realized.
This is when the feeling sinks in. I don't wanna miss you like this. Come back, be here. Come back, be here. I guess you're in New York today. And I don't wanna need you this way. Come back, be here. Come back, be here.
Something that I'm realizing, and I'm seeing and I'm noticing a lot on social media, is that believers, Christians, are fighting against other believers, Christians. Let me tell you, that is the sneakiest trick of the devil. Let me tell you why. Because if you are focused on fighting up against other believers and other Christians, you're going to be too busy to fight up against the enemy himself. He got you too busy. You trying to find problems and mistakes and issues in this person and that person, not yourself. And then you're attacking them instead of him.
I hate it. I hate it. I hate not having intelligent conversations. It's refreshing not playing mental gymnastics and such, but when you can bounce ideas off, you know, two individuals can sit and bounce ideas with each other, and then, you know, man sharpen man is iron sharpen iron. So if I can't learn from you, why are we talking?
Right.
I hate it. I hate it. I hate not having intelligent conversations. It's refreshing not playing mental gymnastics and such, but when you can bounce ideas off, you know, two individuals could sit and bounce ideas with each other, and then, you know, man sharpen man is iron sharpen iron. So if I can't learn from you, why are we talking?
Right.
Hi, I know it's weekend. I know you're at that point in your life where you're saying, not again. Do I get money to take care of the kids for weekend? God is going to do it. Do I need to borrow? No, God is going to do it. Do I need to beg? No, God is going to do it. How? Listen, just ask. And right now, I join my faith with yours to decree and declare that God will show you mercy. The mercy of God will pick you up and clean you up and open up doors for you again. The hand of the Lord will be kind to you. You will experience the love of God in an unusual way. In Jesus' name.
So this morning, I was up and I just wanted to share this with you guys. I was meditating, and, you know, when you get filled with the Holy Spirit, you have to tell people about it. And I was reading from the book of Ephesians. But I couldn't help but to cry, because the things that are in there are what happens in the world that we live in today. It's a lot of killing going on. Children are killing each other just for no reason, no reason, just taking lives. But I'm so grateful for Jesus being the true light and saving me from the darkness.
Demons have a will, they have emotions, they have memory, and they have intellect. Now, this is where Christians are really, most of them have no clue. They don't think that demons have a will. They can will to try to destroy a life. According to the scripture, they come to rob, to kill, and to destroy. They have emotions. I have individuals sometimes, they'll come crying like they're really sorry. And the Lord will tell me, he said, that's not real. He said, they're flowing. He said, behind that face is a demonic spirit. It's just using the sympathy spirit. Open your eyes, people of God. Open your eyes.
Follow for more.
God has blessed me with a message of encouragement that he has wanted me to release to some of his people. This word is about attacks. Some of you guys, right, you've been receiving attacks from the devil. And God has a say in this. And what God said this morning to me was, powerhouse, my people know it themselves that they carry a strong light within them. But I want my people to know that not only do they carry a strong light within them, they are more powerful than they think. You cannot be stopped. You are unstoppable. Every single attack that that is directed towards you and comes your way is like a wave that shows itself to be big and strong, but gets beaten by my protection around you. You will continue to stand mighty and strong no matter how many attacks surround you. And then God did bless me with a vision, but I received the vision first, but he led me to speak about what it is that he was wanting you guys to know in order for you to understand the revelation properly and in depth. And what God showed me was, I saw a lighthouse in the middle of the sea. A strong wave attempted to take the lighthouse out and destroy it, but the wave smashed against the surface and was battered. So specifically, God wanted me to mention, right, that this lighthouse being in the middle of the sea, right, the sea was representing the adversity that you guys are going through, and the lighthouse in the center of the sea, right, is representing you receiving attacks and adversity from the devil left, right, and center in this time, right? And God is also saying to some of you that what he said at the beginning of the message, right, powerhouse, God meant lighthouse, right? But he used the word powerhouse because he is wanting some of you guys to know that you are a light, but you are a light filled with my power. God's power is within you and you are a light with his power. So that's why he said powerhouse. But God is saying to some of you, getting into this message now, and before I get into this message and give you more of the revelation, please ensure that you take this word back to God. And if you've never seen me before, please also take my name back with you so that you can ensure that I'm not a false prophet of God. But God is saying to some of you that you are receiving attacks from the devil left, right, and center in this time, right? It could be to do with your career, right? You know, like the devil's trying to attack you with like just doubt or whatever it may be. I don't know specifically what your situation is, but God is saying to some of you that this adversity that you're facing, the devil is intimidated by you. The devil is intimidated by you because you are a lighthouse. You are a lighthouse. God is saying that you are a lighthouse and you are unstoppable. The way God, you know, blessed me with this like revelation and specifically the vision, right? The waves coming at the lighthouse, they literally like, you know, when something like when you see it at the sea, like the waves crash onto the rock and then the rock stands mightily, but the waves just like disappear into thin air. God is saying to some of you that these attacks are just disappearing when they're coming at you because my protection is over you, is upon you. Be strong and courageous, my son, my daughter.
As makeup artist Candy. Spontaneity is magic. Imperfection is beauty. Flaws are underrated. Beauty is so subjective. The most beautiful things in life are simple yet wholesome. The idea of beauty, I believe, got eroded gradually. Thanks to media and pop culture, what was once beautiful is now called shabby minus. Unkempt hair. Freckled face, fat thighs, hairy legs and armpits, stretch marks and cellulite. When the models on the billboards and magazines are just like you and I, behind those numerous filters, we deem to be perfect. Perfected faces, makeup artist Candy, come see.
Well, I haven't seen you in a while. Yeah, I miss the sight of your beautiful smile. I miss the feeling of your skin touching mine. I can't wait till Friday night. I'll be going to your place.